Hello, so this is just continuing on from my last video about youth, older people, and today's generation. I won't make this too long. Before I forget, I'd like to just have a shout out to my friend Richie. I'll give you a link to his channel. Richie's a musician, and it's obviously something he enjoys doing. He does a lot of covers. I think he's got talent. And it's obviously something he enjoys doing. He's a great lad, so just check out his channel, and if you can, subscribe. And I'd like to thank Richie for helping me get started up on YouTube. He's given me some tips and so on. So cheers, Richie. Okay, just continuing on from I'll put a link to Richie's channel just in the description below, just so you know. Okay, so just continuing on from the last video, I was discussing youth today and how they are influenced by society around them, older people and so-called generation gap and so on. And I won't add too much to what I've already said in the last video, but I think that I lost my trail of thought now. Basically, people are influenced by the society around them, and that inevitably impacts their generation. I think that people can really let me know your thoughts on this. I've more or less said what I have to say now, so I'm just realizing that I've not much more to add to what I've already said. I would say one thing though about parenting. One criticism often of the UK is that parents are bad. Well, I reject that. Not every parent is bad. A lot of parents do get the right balance, and I would say that's the key word here is balance. Now, I'm not talking about teenagers at this stage. I'm talking about children, and I do differentiate between teenagers and children. You know, you get some teenagers with an older mentality, some teenagers with a younger mentality, but when people say teenage children, it's a contradiction. Being a teenager is a distinct age group. It's a transition between being a child and an adult, and it should be recognized as such. Anyway, some parents, I would use one word here, balance. Okay, now what's wrong with balance when it comes to parenting? There's two sort of extremes I see. Either you get, and this may be more from another video, but I'll mention it here anyway. When I'm in a public coffee shop and sometimes you get children running around and the parents are laughing and they think it's cute, it's really, really not. It's very disrespectful to other patrons. And it's awkward because I can't tell off someone else's child. That's the responsibility of the parent. And what I'll usually do, I won't have a go at the child because it's not their fault if they've been brought up that way, but I will glare at the parent and say, "Can you control your child?" It's very disrespectful, and no one's. I'm not a Victor Meldrew type. For British people, they will know that's an old man in a comedy sketch who's always complaining about things. I think it's great that children can have a good time and so on, but there is a time and a place. And I do feel sometimes British society caters actually too much for children. Virtually every public building, whether it be a museum or you name it, any sort of public attraction, are always under pressure to appeal to children. Now, I understand that to an extent because families with children will want to find something that can appeal to the children as well if they're having a day out. But I think it's wrong to try and make everything appeal to children. There should be some things that are exclusively for adults, where adults can relax and enjoy themselves and not have to worry about pleasing children who are running around. And there needs to be a balanced approach. And I think there is far too much going out of, there's too many public attractions going out of their way to please children because of pressure. I mean, I've nothing against public attractions doing that, but I just think it's a little bit too much. I mean, the world doesn't revolve around children. We should look after children. We should cater for them where appropriate. But if you give children the idea that everything is for them, they'll grow up spoiled. I don't think that's a good approach at all. There has to be some things that are exclusively for adults or older people. Because there are many, many things that cater only for children or cater specifically for children. So it needs to be balanced. And I think parents who don't control the children have really no respect for them at all. It's not the child's fault. I won't be angry with the child because they know no better. But these parents who let their children run around and have this idea that their children can do whatever they want, they really need their head examined. They're deeply irresponsible. Then you have the other extreme, where there's parents who will really beat their children publicly and just yell at their children for the most trivial reasons. And you do get cases of child abuse in the UK. Some people outside Britain seem to think we're a soft touch. Well, I would say actually you do get cases of child abuse in this country, terrible child abuse. I think the best approach, now I'm not a parent, so I'm not going to lecture too much about how people should parent, but it does impact other people if you don't control your children. So I'm saying from that perspective. And I really have no respect for those parents who think their children can do as they please. In this regard, there is an east-west divide. In Asian countries, the so-called tiger mum phenomenon or really, really strict parenting is a lot more emphasized. And I don't entirely agree with that because, like I say, I don't think the hardline disciplinary approach is always right. Children are human beings. They have human rights as much as anyone. Just because they're young and aren't at a stage of always thinking for themselves doesn't mean they don't have certain rights. They do. But we shouldn't spoil children and give them the impression they can have whatever they want. And when they do bad things, I think that's entirely appropriate to make them think twice about it. Not just a little telling off. I mean, if I had a child and they were, for example, to run around and get something over a stranger, I would really shout at them to make them understand that that's unacceptable. So it's about balance, okay? That is a key word here, balance. But that's going off on tangent because the original video was about society influence on young people and so forth and so on. Whereas now I'm talking more about parenting, so I'll go off that subject. Okay, so yeah, I won't make this too much longer, but just let me know your thoughts. Are you a young person? And you know, youth is a very abstract sort of term. I would say, really, you know, you can have this logic of youth as young as you feel. There's some people in their 40s and 50s, even 60s, who have a very youthful spirit. And there's younger people who have really grown up far too fast, or grown up may not be the right word, but they're very boring. They're not enjoying their lives, and they, you know, I think that people should just basically be themselves, and yeah. I also think, you know, when we talk about youth, like I say, it's an abstract term. Sometimes I feel quite old, and I'm really not. I'm 27. I'm really not that old, but sometimes I do feel older. That's just the way I feel. Let me know how old you are, and do you feel that age? Do you feel pressures associated with that age? Let me know your thoughts on this. Do you feel, if you're a young person, do you feel you do get a hard time in the media? Do you think older people give you a hard time? If you're an older person, let's say 50 plus, do you feel that there's too much catering for young people? I honestly see both sides. I treat people as individuals, not I try to avoid treating them by their age. Because the chances are your personality will not change a huge amount in a lifetime. There will be some differences as you learn and develop, but someone who is open-minded when they're 20 are going to be open-minded when they're 70 or 80. Someone who's closed-minded when they're 20, they may change, but there's also a chance that they're not going to change. They'll never leave their own city. There's more to do with individuals than age. So that's it, really. Let me know your thoughts. I think, you know, everyone's influenced by their generation, and really just you know, be yourself. Don't face pressure from others. I personally think some people look ridiculous if they try to look a lot younger or a lot older. I mean, actually, before I finish off this video, I would say one thing. There's been a phenomenon recently with children, toddlers, in fact, being modelled, like grown women, female toddlers being modelled in mini bikinis and so on. I'll just give my view on that. I think it's absolutely appalling. And these parents who say it's harmless need their head examined. That is absolutely inappropriate, to put a bikini on a three-year-old girl. And they say the only perverted people are those who have a problem with it. No. Those of us who have our heads screwed on properly have a problem with it. It's just, it's exploitation of children. It's vile, utterly inappropriate, and it's going to give those young girls a conscience when they're older. Goodness knows what sort of conscience, but I really, really don't think that's healthy, and those parents should be ashamed of themselves. Children should be allowed to be children, and a bikini is clearly something designed for a teenager or an adult, not a child. So it's really inappropriate. Likewise, you know, you get, sometimes I see 60, 70 year olds in a nightclub, and it's not quite as bad, but it's a bit, personally I think it's a bit out of place. Each to their own, but I think it's a little bit desperate in some ways, and that's just my view. I mean, people should grow old naturally. That doesn't mean being stuck in a care home. I completely understand older people who hate the logic of being stuck in a care home for the final days, and I have a lot of respect for older people who are very proactive, whether that be their continuum working or, you know, Jian Comment, who's the oldest person on record to be verified. There's been other claims since, but she was 122 when she died, and she was still very, very active at that age, so that's incredible. I heard about a 98-year-old Japanese woman who was still active in judo. I heard about an old Chinese guy, well into his 70s, who'd done an astonishing feat. It was something like 1,200 press-ups a day, or phenomenal. I'm a relatively strong 27-year-old man, and that baffles me. So it's incredible. Complete respect to them. I heard about one old Australian man whose wife had died, and instead of sort of being in a pit of depression, which no one could blame him for, he decided he was going to backpack all over the world. He met young people along the way, and, you know, maximum respect to him. He's really living his life. I don't think life should stop when you reach a certain age, and I don't think age should prevent you doing certain things. Clearly, in sports, there can be certain limitations in certain sports. For example, boxing, you can't really box much beyond the age of, let's say, 42, 45. There are some limitations, but there are things there'll never be limitations on. Writing, for example. There's been best-selling authors who have started writing well into their 40s and 50s. Catherine Cookson is an example of that, and there's other examples. So don't let age hold you back from doing things you want to do. And what I would say to older people, don't feel terrible because you're a certain age and you think you can't do anything. You can still enjoy life, you can still have an active life. You may not look as young as you once were, but it's all to do, I would say, with spirit, you know. Just try and make the most of life, anybody. And young people, I would say, don't waste time. Take as many opportunities you can, try and appreciate your youth as much as you can. Yeah, that's it. But, you know, being old, I would say, is not necessarily a bad thing either. We always have this desire to be young, 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 but being an older person, I would say there's advantages. You have life experience, you have a lot of things to give in that sense, to talk about. Now, I'm not that age, so I'm not going to talk too much about that, but I'm speaking entirely as a from a perspective of a 27-year-old man. So that's my views. Let me know your thoughts on this, the generation gap, how society influences your age group, and so on. Okay, and why don't you just give me some ideas about what you think about this. Okay, thank you. Take care.